Welcome back. Today we're going to look at a demonstration of an applet called D-field, which represents direction fields, or sometimes called slope fields, like in section 2.2. So we're going to do an example 2.2.3, which talks about the harvested population of deer living in some woods, for example. This is a very general thing, but it uses the logistic growth model, but with a harvesting term. Now, first, I want to show the D field applet itself. We have the input panel where you input the equation window, the parameter expressions, and the display parameters, and then the output direction field where you can click and see the solution given a certain initial condition. Each time I click, I'm giving a different initial condition. It's solving forwards in time and then connecting backwards in time, so we can see where it came from, what initial conditions it came from. And you can continue working through that. Some other pieces that are helpful to see is deleting the orbits. That's the curves that we just did. Like that. We can go back and do some settings, various settings. For example, keyboard input of the initial conditions. Say I want to start at time equals 0, x is equal to 2.45. There we go. And then there's some other things. One important parameter here is if you want to make it only go forward in time, which often is what we use it for, then when you click on it, it only shows a solution starting that initial condition and moving forward in time. Now, this is often the kind of model that we're looking at. We're not representing or modeling what happened before the initial condition, but only what happens after it. So restricting the feasibility window for this model. Okay, so there's some demonstration with the general equation given. Here we have x prime is equal to x squared minus at plus b. Now let's instead insert the equation from page 33 in example 2.2.3. So it starts off with dpdt's, or that's p prime. And we have 0.4p times 1 minus p over 100 minus h. Now, one thing to notice is that we have some parameters that are actually already filled in. So I'm going to replace that 0.4 with an r. That's usually our growth, our exponential growth rate. Put an r down here and 0.4. And then I'm going to take this 100, and that's technically our carrying capacity, often represented with an n, the number. So I'm going to put that over here as 100. And then they have h. Now h is going to be the one that they're focused on. That's why they plug the other values. But it makes it cleaner for me to look at. And let's say we start off with h equals 0, the great place to start. Now the display window. We want to start with time equals 0, often, and then increase in time. And it's not entirely sure how far up we go to fit the window frame on page 33. And so for P, our populations, because the population of deer are probably going to be positive. Okay, so that makes sense. And then not sure exactly if this number scales with the number of deer or the thousands of deer or whatever, but the window given here is 100. And let's just see how that looks. And if we were to plot some example initial condition curves, do we match up a little bit with the behavior shown? Yeah. Maybe go a little bit above 100. One thing, if you want to keep the same solutions, you can use current initial values. And then as you adjust things, like maybe this goes to 110. Maybe this goes, no, I'll do 20. Oh, there we go. Ah, very nice. Now, what's important about that going above 100 is you can actually now see that the behaviors change right around 100, because 100 is the carrying capacity. So you can see exactly where that equilibrium solution is. Okay, now let's change H. The second picture has H equal to 6. Now notice I'm keeping the same initial conditions. Let's just see what happens. As you change the parameters, those initial conditions are recalculated, and you can see most of them will absorb into a new carrying capacity, which is a little bit lower, a shifted carrying capacity in a sense. But one of them, or two of them actually, dive down and go extinct very quickly. Now let's move again to H equals 12 to mimic the third graph. And you can see they all die out. So this is over-harvesting, where all populations of deer go extinct, all initial populations. Okay, so that's a quick demonstration of the use of D-field for various problems. Again, this is for a first-order differential equation. We had an example at the beginning where it had dx dt or x prime, and we changed it to be dp dt or p prime. We inserted some parameters. Sometimes we have numbers. We can replace those numbers with new parameters, list them down below right here. And then we can use some of the effects, I suppose, to help simplify our clicking so that we can easily shift the parameters and see how the changes occur. Now, what's important about these changes occur in the behavior is that we can then look at when those changes, what's the point at which those changes occurred, and those are the bifurcation points that we talk more about in 2.7. Okay, that wraps it up for this video. See you in class.